the web is a place to get information.
The web is trade.
The web is knowledge.
The web is a mystery.
The internet is a fight in a pub.
The web is everything in life, absolutely everything you can imagine life to be, crammed into a matchbox.
When I look at whether social technologies and the social web is a good thing or a bad thing, if it's horrible for society or wonderful for society, I think the reality is that it's here. It's not going away. It's up to people who use it to decide whether it is going to represent the best of human nature or the worst of human nature.
The web is a reflection of society. The web is pornography, gossip, flirting, power plays, people making money. It's life reflected on the web. But the nature of the web, because it allows this ability to create very distributed way and for people to connect and collaborate, it makes things possible in ways that they weren't before.
In the 20th century, if you had something to say in public, you couldn't, period. If you were a citizen but not a media professional, you could not broadcast a message.
The means of production to have your voice heard, to find an audience, to join in, have been hugely costly in the past. You've needed recording studios or television studios or printing presses. Now someone with an iPhone can post a video, make a podcast, connect to someone else. Anyone can have access potentially to a vast audience.
Everything that people are doing in terms of learning how to connect with other people online is towards a common goal. So whether that common goal is sharing news articles or entertaining themselves by listening to amazing music in the context of an artist's website, all of those skills can actually be used for anything. Over 200,000 organizers have come together in a social activism network and changed the course of wind energy policy in the United States.
What you get in the web is all of the contending of special interests that you expect in a democracy, but you don't get many of the mechanisms for defending the overall process or outcome from those special interests. The big question around the Obama administration was, will he govern like he campaigned? Will the Obama administration show the same zeal for public input and participation that the Obama campaign did? So the day after the election, they announced change.gov, right? And they invite people in to tell the Obama administration what issues they should care about. In the middle of two wars and the biggest financial meltdown in 70 years, the thing the Obama administration should most focus on is medical marijuana. The reason that that was at the top of the list wasn't that that's what a majority of citizens wanted. Rather, it was because the people who wanted that thing were the most organized and they were able to get their message out. So the web is really good at factionalization and special interests and empowering people to have incredibly loud arguments all hours of the day and night. But it's not at all good at figuring out of the massive signal that argument generates what any group of people should do.
The web isn't a sort of utopian collective. It's a kind of constantly evolving thing, and that is what is so important about it. The cost is you also get this huge volatility as things come and go and change, but the underlying logic of it all is it's created a new menu of options for us to get things done together in new ways. So in that sense, it's not simply reflecting how society is, it's opening up options for us to behave and be in different ways. And that's what's really significant about it.
It's a new form of culture, and the culture will range from playfulness and inefficiency to the most serious accomplishments and achievements of humanity.
You can actually impact the lives of someone sitting in a country hundreds of thousands of miles away that is wrought with political strife. The social web can do more good in the world than it can do bad. And it's the choice of people and the people who are using it as to what they want to do with it.